So first, what is a mechanism? A mechanism is an assembly of bodies connected to manage forces and movements in the machine. In Automation Studio, Mechanism Manager allows you to create mechanical links between bodies, fluid power actuators, to simulate their kinematic and dynamic interactions. Let's see the terminologies of the Mechanism Manager first. In Mechanism Manager, we use four terms to create a mechanism. Those are frame, node, body, and joints. First, what is a frame? A frame is a fixed body or a point in a mechanism. A node is a point where a mechanical joint can be made and or a force can be applied. A body is a part of the machine acted upon by the actuators or the loads and are attached to the frame. When we say body, it is a physical body of the machine in real life. And joints. A joint is a point where connection between two links are designed to provide desired movement, for example, sliding movement or rotational movement. So now let's see what are all the steps involved in creating a simple mechanism. Basically, we have categorized in five steps in creating a mechanism. The first step is to define the frame and add nodes to the frame. Then second step is to create bodies and add nodes to the bodies. And the third step is to add fluid power actuators to the mechanism. Now you have frame, bodies, and fluid power actuators. And the next step is to create linkages between frame, bodies, and fluid power actuators. The final step is to manage loads. Mechanism Manager now allows you to put a load at any point in the mechanism. For example, you can apply load at this point, or here, or this point, to see the effect of the mechanism in the fluid power systems. Now let's move to the Automation Studio software and see how we can create a simple mechanism. So ahead of time, I've created a simple circuit to show you how to create a mechanism. So as you can see here, this simple circuit contains a linear actuator with a proportional directional control valve, which is controlled by a joystick, and also we have a simple pressure relief valve as well as a fixed displacement pump. So if you see the left side, we have this a simple boom lift mechanism. This is the example which we are going to create for today's webinar. So if you see in this diagram here, I have already created the structure. This is the lift boom of this machine. And we have a fluid power actuator here. And there are some properties associated with the fluid power actuator is also shown here. And there are two fixed points here, 0,0 and 0,250. So one thing I want to stress here is that before creating a mechanism manager, it is very important that you set up all the properties of the linear actuator or other actuators. Because once you create and associate a mechanism with these linear actuators, you will not be able to change or modify the properties of this actuator. So first, let's set up the component properties of this linear actuator. How do we do it? It's very simple. You just have to double click on it. I'll just move a little bit to the right so that I'll be able to see this actual properties here. So now I'm going to set up the cylinder stroke, which is 200 millimeters. By default, you can see here there is a 200 millimeter stroke. And there is a rod diameter, which is 50 millimeters, and the piston diameter, 100 millimeter. Now I have set up all the properties here. And now I will close this component properties here. So the reason why I have all the coordinates set up already set up is that this will allow me to configure the mechanism very quickly and very fast. So this will save a lot of time in creating a mechanism. So it is always better that you have a simple mechanism with all the coordinates in your hand. So now, how to access the mechanism manager? First, go to the fluids tab. Then you can see here there's a mechanism manager. You can click on it. As soon as I click on it, you can see here there's a mechanism manager window pops up. In this window, you can add a mechanism here to this project or delete a mechanism using this button. So now I'm going to add a new mechanism to this project by clicking this button here. So when you see here, as soon as I click on this add mechanism, you can notice two things here. The first one is the mechanism viewer window automatically opens up. This mechanism viewer window will allow you to monitor the mechanism that you are creating, or it will allow you to view the mechanism that you have already created. The second thing is, in this left pane of this mechanism manager dialog box, there is a frame which is default. So for any mechanism, we need to have a standard fixed frame or a point. So that is standard over here. You can also modify the name of the mechanism by accessing this identification tab. So let's call this one as a boom lift mechanism. So now as soon as I enter it here, the name modifies in this description box over here. As I mentioned it before, the first step in creating a mechanism is to define a frame and add nodes to the frame. So now what we are going to do is we are going to define the frame as a first step. For that to do, you just have to click on the frame. As soon as you click on the frame, you can see here there are two tabs in the right window opens up. The first one is the data tab. The second tab is the mechanical nodes tab. This mechanical nodes tab will allow you to add, delete, copy, or paste the mechanical nodes that you are creating. So first, according to our example here, I'll just move this one bit to the right. So according to our example here, we have two fixed frames here, one at this point and one here. So I'm going to add two nodes to the frame. The first node by clicking here, node one, and second node. You can also rename this node by going to the identification tab here. So let's say cylinder, I'll just open this one here, and I'll just say cylinder attachment point. And then I go up here in the node one, and then I say where we are going to attach the body of our mechanism. So I will say like body attachment point. So now you see here the name changed here as well, body attachment point and the cylinder attachment point. Now what I'm going to do means basically here in the mechanism viewer here, you can see the points as well. You can also zoom the mechanism. As you configure one by one frame, body and the joints, you can keep on monitoring using this mechanism viewer as well. So now I'm going to transfer these points to the node points here in this one here. So first is the cylinder attachment point, which is here basically, which is 0, 0, and all dimensions are in millimeter, just for reference here. So first point is 0, 0, I will leave it as it is. And the second point is the body attachment point. I select this one and I wanted to change it to 0, 250. So I will just go to the technical characteristics. Here I'm just going to enter 0 in the X coordinate and 250 in the Y coordinate. You can also change the units by accessing to the right a small tab here. Meters, centimeters, millimeters, inches, etc. So I will leave it to millimeters here. So now we have set up 2 points in this one. To view those 2 points in the mechanism viewer, you can just click on the zoom mechanism here. So now we can see here the first point, which is the body attachment point. And when I select the second point, it automatically highlights here in the mechanism viewer. So far what we have done, we have selected the frame and we have configured the nodes here. Now, the second step is to create bodies and add nodes to the bodies. So before creating bodies, if you see here, in the left side of the mechanism manager, the left pane, you can see here there's add body icon and add joints, different types of joints. For example, pivot joint, a slider joint, and a rigid links between two bodies. And also you can add external load to the joints. So now we are going to add a body to this mechanism here. The body is the boom lift of our mechanism in our example. So I will say add a body. As soon as I add a body, you can see here a body icon appears here with a small question mark to its left. Basically, this means that this body is not linked to any mechanism or is not configured properly. When you have a check mark, it's correctly configured, just for identification here. So now, in our example, in the body, we have 3 points here, 1, 2, and 3. So I'm going to create 3 nodes to this body here. Let's say 1, 2, and 3. And I will rename the nodes according to the requirements, and I just say like node 1, we will say a frame attachment point. And then I go to the second point, which is where we are going to attach our rod in the cylinder, rod of the cylinder. So let's say rod attachment point. Now let's go to the third node, and we will say that, let's say if you wanted to have some external load acting at this point here, so we will call it as external load point. So now we have set up the 3 points here, but still if you see in the coordinate system, it's still 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0, 0. So now I'm going to transfer these coordinate points to this body points here. So first, let's select the frame attachment point. Once again, it's the same way. Go to the technical characteristics and then set up the points as we see here. So 0, 250. As soon as I put this one, you can see here it automatically moves, the point moves to the top. And let's say the second point I'm selecting, it's -550, 250. So now zoom mechanism, you can see here the second point is here. And I will say the third point now, which is this one, -1,100, 250. So now you see here there is a 3 points created, but still we don't have the same shape as this body frame here. So why is it like that? This is because still the center of mass of this body is located at the origin. If you look at it here, the center of mass is still located at 0, 0. We have to move this one to more realistic position. So let's say I will move it to the second node point, and I'll select the center of mass, go to the technical characteristics, and I say like minus 550, comma 250. So now if you see here, you can see the straight line as like a lift. In our example, we have created this mechanism here. You can also rename the body by accessing the data tab. I'll just go back once again here, and I save this one as boom. And you can also change the appearance in the mechanism by changing the color here and also line thickness. Let's say I put it to 12 and be more realistic. So now you see here that we have configured our body of the machine here. So we have configured the frames and we have configured our body in the mechanism manager. Now the third step is to add the actuators to this mechanism manager. How do we add a actuator to this mechanism manager? It's very easy. As like before, you just have to drag and drop this linear actuator into this left window here. It will automatically be added to our mechanism manager. So when I add a linear actuator, you see there are 2 points, a cylinder and a rod. And there is a small internal link. This internal link is created because we have an internal link between the cylinder and rod here, so which will be created automatically, so you don't have to worry about it. Now, when I click on the cylinder, you can see it automatically we have by default 3 nodes is there. The first one is cylinder reference and the center of mass and the cylinder fixture. What are the three points here? So I'll just show you a quick example here. So if you see here in this cylinder here, this is the origin of the cylinder by default. So this is where 0, 0 is, and this is where the center of mass is located. And if I just move a bit closer here, so by default you can see a 250 center of mass is located at 250, 0, which is basically 250, 0 in the y direction. And the third point is the cylinder fixture. The cylinder fixture is the point where you physically attach the cylinder to a machine. So we are not going to attach at the origin, so basically we will attach a small point behind. So that's where we have it -100, 0, which is located at this point here. This is where you fix your cylinder. So basically this is how these 3 points are created, just to aid us to create the mechanism quickly. In the same way, if I access the rod, we have 3 points, a rod reference, a center of mass, and the rod fixture. What are these 3 points here in the rod reference? So I'll just grab this one here. So if you see here in the rod reference, this is the local origin of this rod, and this is where the center of mass is located here. So it's 250, 0. And if you just look at it, the rod fixture in this one, it's this point. So from the origin to this rod fixture, it's 500 millimeters, 0. It's located at this point. So for example, in your case, if it's too long, the rod is too long, you can modify the length after coming here, and you can adjust it according to your requirements. So now Now we have 3 points created, and we have added actuator to this mechanism. First, we created a frame and added nodes to this mechanism. The second, we created a body and added nodes to this body here using mechanism manager. And the third step, we have added the fluid power actuators to it. So now, what is the next step here? The next step is, now we have defined all these three things, and now the next step is to create linkages by defining joints between these 2 points. First, let's say I want to create link between this frame and the body. If you look at the, in our mechanism viewer, we have only like a created body and the frame, and we have added the cylinder, but we haven't created any links so far. So the step is to create link. How do we create a link? It's very easy. If you look at here, add a pivot joint, a slider, or rigid link joints. This is how you create a link. First, I'm going to add a pivot joint. As soon as I add a pivot joint here, you can see there are changes in the right side of this mechanism manager. First point is the first node. Basically, it is asking for which node you wanted to create the link, the pivot link. First, I will select the body and frame attachment point. So we have named this boom, frame attachment point. I'll select this one. As soon as I select it, it will show all the possible points where you can fix this frame attachment point of the boom. So now I'm just going to click on this frame of the body attachment point. So now I have selected two points, and I'm going to validate this point by selecting this one, by applying this check mark here. So when I apply the check mark, you can see here automatically there is a small link created. You can also zoom in. So you can see here there is a small blue color appearing here. So which basically indicates that we have created link at this point. And you can also see here it's correctly configured, this pivot joint. And there is also small check mark here available here. So the next step. The next step is to create a links between the cylinder and the frame, as well as the rod and the body. So for that, I'm going to add another pivot joint. So now you see here another pivot joint is added. And the same way, I'm going to select the cylinder fixture in the first node. And as soon as I select all the points where you can attach this cylinder fixture, it's shown here in the second node window here. So now I'm going to attach this point to this frame, cylinder attachment point. So I'll select these two ones, and I validate this selection. As soon as I validate it, you can see there's a small selection appears, but still you don't see the cylinder up here because you did not configure the rod. So now we have to attach the rod to this body. When you attach the rod to this body, you can see here the fluid power actuator automatically shows here. So now I'm going to add another pivot joint. And I just go down. You can see here there is a rod fixture. So I select this one. In the second node point, it automatically shows that there is only one point where you can attach this rod. So which is basically this point here. So I will select this one, I apply this one. As soon as I validate this one, you can see here a small message is created, which basically is telling you that the extension of the cylinder has been set to 2.08. This is because of the physical constraints of the mechanism. So I press OK in this one here. So if you see here in this one, all these values are now constrained here. Correctly configured, and all these values are validated. And in the mechanism viewer, if you see here, the mechanism is created as per our example. So now that we have set up our example here, let's see like if this is the mechanism that we wanted to have. Exactly. So I'll just close this one. I'll go down and I will run the simulation now to see like the mechanism that we created is exactly what we require. So I'll just say normal simulation here. And I'm going to control the joystick over here. So as soon as you see here, there is a fluctuation in the mechanism. Why do we have this fluctuation in this one here? Because we did not properly constrain all this linkages here. So now let's go back to the mechanism to fix all the constraints properly. So now I'm going to click on the fluid, and in the fluid manager, mechanism manager. So now I have selected this one. To set up a constraint, first I need to select the point where I wanted to set up a constraint. So let's select the pivot one joint because this is where we have the problem. So we have like the fluctuations back and forth there. So I will select the first point, pivot one. So it's highlighted here. And after that, when you go down to the joint properties, and there is a technical characteristics available where you can set up your angular damping, stiffness, or free angle values if you require. And the initial angle basically represents the initial position of this body, so which is set to 0 degrees now. And next, we go down to the operating conditions. This is where exactly you set up your constraints of the mechanism. So the first one is the joint limit behavior. So here it's by default it's ignored. Now I'm going to change it to stop. So now we are going to set up the angle constraints for this pivot joint here. So I will say the minimum angle is minus 80 degrees and the maximum angle is 0 degrees. Why did I say 0 and minus 80 degrees? 0 degrees is the initial angle of the body that we set up here. So that's why I'm saying this is the maximum limit to which the pivot can move, and the minimum angle is minus 80 degrees. Basically, when you have the clockwise rotation, it's going to be minus, and anti-clockwise is positive convention. So I put a minus 80 degrees so that the body can move up to minus 80 degrees and come back to 0 degrees. So now we have set up our operating conditions here. Then I will close the mechanism and I will see like if it is set up properly. I'll go to the simulation here, normal simulation, and I joystick and I move this one. Now if you see here, automatically it stopped at that point at minus 80 degrees and it comes down to 0 degrees here. So now the mechanism is set up properly according to our requirements. So now we wanted to analyze the circuit. Why do we need a mechanism manager here? This is why do we need a mechanism manager is because we can set up, previously we used to add loads to the cylinder separately, so which will be acted only at the rod end. Now with this mechanism manager, what you can do means you can set up a complete mechanism of the machine, and you can apply load at any point, anywhere. So the effect of this complete load is taken into account in the hydraulic system. So now, let's analyze the circuit first. So for analyzing the circuit, I'm just going to add a simple measuring instrument for now, a node measuring instrument. And I pick one of these rod end, right, piston end. I see pressure in bar and a rod inside, a pressure. We have set up two pressure measuring instruments at the two ends to see what effect, what is the pressure required to lift this boom here. So now I will do the slow motion simulation here, just to see the how much pressure it requires to lift the cylinder. So as soon as I move, you can see here, it requires somewhere between like 0 to 10 bar pressure to lift the cylinder. So let's say I wanted to add external load to this point and see what effect it has on the cylinder. For that, I'll once again go back and access the mechanism manager. Click on the mechanism manager here. And as I said, there's an add external load tab here. You can click on it. So as soon as you add, this also has question mark. Basically, this is saying that the load is not correctly defined. So now we are going to define the load. You will select the point where you wanted to apply the load. Let's say I wanted to apply a load at this point here, so which is body and the external load. I'm going to look for body boom and the external load point. I'll select this one. And under this load properties, you can go to the technical control characteristics. This technical control characteristics, you can see there is X active force and there is a Y active force. And also you can apply a torque acting on this mechanism at this point. So let's say I wanted to apply a load of 1000 kilograms at this point here. So I'll just say 1000, and you have to have, remember that the convention is same. When it's moving from top to bottom, it's the negative direction, and from here it's positive direction in the Y, and positive X direction is here, and the negative X direction is this side. Let's say we apply load in the negative Y direction, so I'm just going to say minus 1000 deca-newton. You can also change the units here. So now I have applied the load, selected the point. We have to validate it. We just validate it by the selection. And then I close this one here. So let's see what effect this load has on this mechanism. Go to the simulation, a slow motion simulation here. Change this actuator here. So now you see here it requires like 65 to 70 bar load, and it's still not enough to lift this boom. So in order to set up, we can just access the cracking pressure, and we can increase the pressure so that you can optimize the circuit in much better way. So let's say, like, let's put it 200 bar. It's still not enough, so I'll just increase it to 234, so you can see here it's now standardly configured. So this is how you can create a mechanism, and you can apply loads at any point in the system here. You can either apply load at this point or here. If you wanted to apply a load, you have to create your own nodes, and you can apply a node here as well at any point, and you can run the simulation and you can see the effect of those things in the mechanism as well. So previously we used to add load curves to see the effect of this mechanism. So if I just open the home tab and I open one of the cylinders here, if you see here, previously we used to go to the cylinders tab and access force curves. Here we just add some loads to this point here. So like if you wanted to see the effect of this role of the cylinder, we used to add force curves. And now with the mechanism manager, this allows you to set up the load. So automatically it will take the force curves by itself. If I access this cylinder, which is we have created and associated with the mechanism manager, you can see here now the force curve is currently disabled. So this allows you to save a lot of time in setting up the force curves, so and then you can use it very quickly. So this is how you can use the mechanism manager and the steps. To wrap up with the presentation, I just wanted to go back again. So then after I will wrap up, we can go through the questions that you may have. So if you see here, once again, getting back to the normal presentation here. So the first, we have defined the frame and added notes to the frame, as you see, and then we have created the bodies and added notes to the bodies. Then the third step, we have dragged and dropped the linear actuator to the mechanism. And the fourth step, we have linked all these three together, like frames, bodies, and the fluid power actuators by defining their joints. Then we have added some loads to see the effect of the loads in the mechanism manager.